Hello there, amazing and wonderful geeky people of YouTube. So, I don't know why I said that, but I'm crazy. I just literally came home from work. I'm sitting in my fat ass on my fat ass again, and I will just be talking. There will not be any fancy Linuxy thingy Medusky going on the screen. I need to get up a little bit here. I'm falling down in my chair. There will not be any green craps or what you will call it. So you can basically just minimize this so you don't have to look at my ugly face and get nightmares for the rest of your life and stuff like that. So I want to talk about something called the human factor, and it's something that everyone forgets when we're talking about getting people to switch to Linux. I'm one of those guys. I want more people using Linux, because if more people use Linux, Linux would be better, more companies would, you know, make their programs forward, and so on and so on and so on. So it's in everyone's interest to get more people on this wonderful platform. But when we are doing videos about why you should switch to Linux and all that shit, we are talking about the technology behind it. Better kernel, better programs, better blah 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 and all that. And it's, this is one that really makes me really really laugh. Linux is free. Well, most people don't buy a license for Windows, so for them it's free also. They buy a laptop, they buy a PC, they buy whatever that has like a rescue CD or rescue partition on the hard drive that they have Windows on it. And then once in a blue moon, like every 4, 5, 6, 10 years, they have to buy a new version of Windows, and they're like, yeah, I have to pay a little bit, and then I don't have to pay for 5 or 6 years again. That's kind of free for them also. You get my idea here? So this notion that Linux don't cost you any money for a desktop user, we're not talking support licenses and company licenses and all that shit, but for us, me, you, desktop users, it don't really have any merits, to be honest. What has the biggest impact on getting people to convert to Linux is what I call the human factor. It's everything that has nothing to do with technology. Why are people still using Windows? Well, they know it. Like I said, it comes pre-installed on a lot of PCs. And if Linux today came pre-installed on, Windows come pre-installed on a lot of PCs and not CDs, I think it's at CDs. Use your brain. But let's get into it again here. So if Linux today came pre-installed on a lot of PCs, or you have the opportunity for it, most people will not choose it. Fact. Why? Familiarities, I think that's the word. I'm Danish, so I can't speak English. Or they know Windows. They know Windows. That's the problem. When people sit down in front of a PC with a mouse in their hand, I don't know if you can, I actually have a wireless mouse, so I can show it to you guys. Hey! When they put a mouse in their hand, they sit down with a keyboard. They associate that with Windows, because that's what they've been used to. And Windows looks almost the same from 95 till now when they first came out with the GUI. You have a taskbar, you have a start button. A 95 user that have never used a PC other than Windows 95 could still, with a bare minimum of training or with little problems, use Windows 10 nowadays. Can we say the same with Linux? No. Linux is so drastically different from Windows that a lot of people will just be like, I have Windows, it works for me, I don't want to spend time learning Linux, I don't have the, be willing to do it because I have other interests. Blowing the morn, playing golf, play with your wife and kids, stuff like that. That's the human factor, that's what we forget. We are so good at promoting Linux from a technical side, but not so good from the human side. And it's hard to convert people. You know this saying, you cannot learn an old dog new tricks. And that's kind of what we are forgetting when we are talking about Linux. The world is brought up with Windows as its main working environment, as the desktop users. And that's what people know. That's what people expect as an experience on a PC. And I'm not saying that Linux should mimic Windows 100%, but we need to be close in the beginning, so it becomes as seamless as possible. Just the fact that we have app senders You know, you can't go to any website and just download a program and then double click it and it installs. That's what Windows users are used to. But on Linux, we have app stores, we have app centers, we have, you know, programs that text from repositories and all that. And that's so new for people that alone that is a big paradigm we need to shift. And I know, but you will say, oh, well, I don't have my phone on me. People are using phones with app centers and tablets. Yeah. But they associate the phone with an app center and the tablet with an app center. Ever since Windows 95 or before that, the home computer experience have not been associated with an app center. It is learnable. But let's just for the sake of it, say my mom comes and she's like, oh, I want to use this Linux thing. She wants to install a program. For some reason, Google Chrome is not in the repositories. Obviously, just go on to Google Chrome, download the deb file or RPM file because, oh, download for Linux, just click it. And then she expects to just be able to double click it and then, option, you can use the program. Well, if she downloaded the deb file and she was on a Debian-based system, that would work. If she was on Arch, that's another problem. And this is here where the fragmentation in Linux is a really, really big problem also. Because the human factor plays in again. What distribution should I use? Hello, Mr. Linux geeky boy that never showers. What distribution should I use? Well, if you're into this kind of philosophy and this, or if you like this desktop environment and blah, we could go on for hours. They're like, oh my, I just want a system I can plug in and use and look at cat pictures and my family photos with me in a bikini and stuff like that. That's all they want. They don't want to sit down and invest time in this whole new experience they want to learn. That's not what most people want. Like I said, they just want sit on their ass, take on some stuff. They basically want a system that just works and gets out of their way with minimum learning curve as possible. People only change if they really, really have to, or if the situation they're in is inconvenient for them. Meaning, most people don't start to lose weight until it becomes a problem for them. Most people, I can play football, I can do this and that, and yeah, I have a couple of pounds extra on me, who gives a fuck? And then one day they get too high blood pressure and they're like, oh shit, now this is actually becoming a convenience for me. I have to do something about it. Most people think that way. That's why only 1% or is it 2% of the whole world's population is actually active doing some form of fitness. So if you're doing, no matter what it is, taking walks every day and stuff like that, you're in the top, let's just say 5% of the world. Most people don't think about that. Subject for another video, maybe. But like I said, people only change when they really, really have to. Will a day come where people really, really have to switch to Linux? No. It won't. I'm sad to say it, but we have to be realistic here. We need to go into the hearts and minds of people. And by talking about technical stuff, oh, you know, you get this software center and you get this stability and antiviruses and blah, 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 blah. It will just go bloop, 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 over most people's said. They don't really give a flying cow about that. They get viruses and extra search bars on their browser and stuff like that. They want to know, oh, how do I fix that? How do I get rid of that? That's the only thing they want to know. They don't want to know that there's a system out there. Yes, you have to learn new paradigms. You have to modify your behavior a little bit to get it to work. But it's amazing and it's really, really great technology. It's kind of like if I take, let's say, someone that's really, really into stamp collection and say to him, you know what, this car stuff here, it's really, really good for you to learn how to fix a car and stuff. It's kind of the same thing. They don't want to. For them, the operating system is just another gadget. It's just a watch. It's just like a plectra for, you know, a tool. That's all it is. They don't care about what goes into make this. What kind of material is this made of? Is it made in China? No. Again, here, a good analogy. We are talking about this. Oh, Windows, Linux is free. It's open source. We don't have so much proprietary, and everyone can look at it and all that. That's kind of like me saying to you: you should be worried about all that your technology is made in China. You should really, really focus on that. You should do something about it. It's not good. Most people just say, I don't give a fuck if my watch is made in China. It works. I can see the clock. It don't break. My iPhone is made in China. I don't give a fuck. My sneakers are made in China. My t-shirt is made in China. I don't give a fuck. It's cheap. It work. It don't get in my way. It don't affect my life. That's how people see the world. That's the human factor. We need to talk to the human factor to promote Linux better. How do you do that, you crazy Danish idiot? I don't know. I'm not a psychiatrist. Marketing can have something to do with it, but unless people get forced into using Linux, or Windows becomes so much of a problem for them that they have to switch to Linux, that's the only scenarios I can see them switching to Linux by themselves. Another thing now that I've said by themselves, you should never force feed people the Linux idea, just like you should never force feed people any way of life, idea, philosophy, religion, or name it. You should not force feed it to people. If I tell someone that you are driving a Ford, that's wrong because blah, 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 blah. I am not attacking their car. I'm attacking their idea, their choice, the way that they spend their money. I'm actually, how it sounds to them is that I'm attacking them as a person, that they feel that they are a bad person. So if you go up to a Windows user and say, you should use Linux because Microsoft take telemetry and blah, 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 and all, and they're like, it just came at the fucking PC, dude. Why are you attacking me and yelling at me and trying to make me change something that just works for me? You get what I'm saying here? So we need to be better about the human factor. Again, I don't know how to do it. I hope that to some extent that I am trying to do it, because I like to not tell people what to do. I try to not tell people what to do when I'm talking about Linux distribution and all that. The best thing for Linux right now could be that we had a standard base. So if anyone said, okay, I want to try out Linux, which distribution should I use? That one. That one over there. That's the one you should use. We need one we can say that to. Because most people, again, the human factor, most people, 90% of the world, when it comes to technology in this aspect here, they just want to be told what to do and how to do it. Kind of like when you put your car into your mechanic, you don't want to have the mechanic go up to, okay, listen here, my friend. You know that gasket here that makes sure that you don't mix your fluids together? That's broken. So here you have to understand how the internal combustion engine works, because it's really, really important that we fix that. And we cannot use this brand that's a little bit cheap because it's made by child labor in China. So we need to have you to pay us a little bit more money so we can get this one made in America, that's made under controlled supervision and all that, and upholding the Greenpeace laws and blah and all that shit. But you kind of have to go with us and help us put it in so you know what goes into it. Would you go to that kind of mechanic? No, you just want to say, not working, fix it. That's how most people see computers. We are so unfortunate that us group here, we like geeking out about Linux. We like geeking about technology. We like geeking out about computers. But we are like a small, small spectrum of the people using computers. A way that I see could be a good way to get people to use Linux at home and go into this human factor, as I called it, is that if they started to use it at work, and which is slowly starting to do right now. Because let's face it, where do you spend most of your adult time? At work. And if you're working with computers, well, it's Windows you're getting exposed to. If we expose more people on the work environment to Linux, so they get familiar with it on Linux, because people, for some reason, don't mind getting a new truck at work, or a new robot that do new things on the production line and stuff like that. They can understand that because, oh, I get paid for this. This is part of my work. So I kind of have to learn to use it to stay employed. So if the company said, well, now we are switching to Linux, and the accountants and blah, 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 they have to start and learn Linux. And they're like, it's a hassle, but I get paid to learn it, so I don't mind as much as if I had to do it in my spare time. And then they get exposed to it and they figure out, oh, it's not that bad. And they will think, oh, I can use that at home. I could just go home and download Ubuntu or whatever and use it at home. I really, really do think that's the way to do it, because like I said, yeah, I have to learn a new accounting software. I have to learn a whole new way how this, the CAD system work, or because I'm used to Windows, but I'm getting paid to take the courses, I'm getting paid for this, so I don't give a fuck, I don't mind, I'm willing to learn. Where if I said to you, you have to learn this on your own time, without getting paid for it, they would just be, you know what, I have this Linux Windows box, it just works, I can play my games, I can watch my porn, I can chat with my kids and my grandparents, no need for me to change. Where if they got exposed on the work site, and they already have learned and they got some courses on Linux and they get a better understanding of it, basically got paid to learn it, they would be like, oh, I can use that at home. You get my idea here? And it's something we need to talk about. And that's why all these, oh, Windows 7 is going out of life, so now everyone will flock to Linux. No. What do people know? Windows. What do people used to use? Windows. What will people use? Windows. Are they willing to pay 40, 50, 60 bucks for a Windows machine? Yes. Why? Because it came, first of all, they probably have not paid for Windows 7 anyway because it came with their PC. And they had that for years. So 60 bucks for them, if you say like, oh, how much per day have I paid for this license? Or how much per day, per month have I paid for Windows? It's like pocket change if you really think about it. And that's how they think. Oh, I have to give out a little bit more and then I have to wait, like I said, 10 years before I have to do that again. Who gives a fuck? We need to get this human side in, side of it into, because this is a big problem when I go down the rabbit hole of why people are not using Linux, is that we are really good at the technology behind it. We're really good at explaining people why they should do it. But we are not as good at convincing them in here. They understand that it's better. They understand it's more secure. They understand that it's more stable. But in their eyes, Windows is not doing anything bad to them. It's not making their life inconvenient. Even if they get viruses, even if they get ransomware. Because first of all, they know what it is. They grew up with Windows. From school to now, for the most part, or Macintosh in some cases. So it's familiar to them. They know it. And that's also another thing I also have talked a lot about in some of my other videos, is that Linux needs to get into schools. Because those, like I said, you can't teach an old dog new tricks. Teach the young kids. Teach the young crowd. That's the target group we should go for. Because if they get exposed to Linux at an early age, they don't have all of this backlog of Windows knowledge and Windows indoctrination, if you can call it like that. They don't have all that in their heads. They're kind of like fresh sheet of paper. So it's easier to convince them to use Linux. I am not the future of Linux as a user. You are not the future. If you watch this video and you are 18 years old or 25 or something like that, you are not the target group for the future of Linux. It's the young crowd or people at the workplace. But I do believe that the young crowd is the biggest audience that you have to take. So that means that we will only see the return of the investment in like 10, 15 years. And at that point, will everything just be in the cloud? Are we just having a dongle? Now this is a mouse, but just imagine this was a USB stick or something like that you put into like a hub. Bloop. And then you have a screen, you have peripherals, and now it's basically like the case you have for all your components in, it's just like in your phone. That was the premise of the Ubuntu phone back in the day, was that you have a phone, you plug it into a station, and now you have a full-fledged Ubuntu system on your hand. I think that's the future, and I do think it may be the phone. And in this case, most people are using Android and iOS. And then you just plop it. I have to make a video about that. This is going out of the subject here. But you get my idea. We need to talk to the human side. To people to make them switch. Not just blabbing a lot of technology. Tech slang and tech words and command line this. And, you know, SSH and, you know, security this. And app armor, firewalls. And they will just be like, but we forget that because we are interested in that. We are interested in it. And like I said before with the whole Windows 7 thing, it's hot air, man. It won't happen. the people that used Windows 7 that will switch to Linux have already switched to Linux. Just like the people that would have switched to Mac when by at the end of life of Windows 7 would already have switched to Mac. That's now we are talking about Mac. I have some Mac friends and I'm like, why are you using Mac? I get two answers. I got exposed to it at home by my parents when I was a kid, or I got exposed to Macintosh via my work. They're graphic designers and stuff like that. That's why they switched to Mac. Not because it's better, not because blah blah blah. There are some people that are doing that, but for the that's what I hear the most for people that have been long-term Mac users, is that I got exposed to it as a kid, during my childhood, during education, or at work. That opened my eye up for this Macintosh system here. That's what we need to do with Linux. And we need to be better at talking to people in a non-nerdy, geeky, technical way. I've been using Linux since the mid-90s, okay? And already back then, I was talking to my mom about Linux. And she was just like, what the fuck are you talking about? She was like 55 before I got her to use a fucking PC, like have her own PC. Other than that, it was always her boyfriends that had PCs, and she was like just playing like solitaire on it once in a while. But now, like almost 10 years ago, I got her to get her own laptop. And I was like, oh, you have to use Linux and blah, blah, blah. And she's like, well, who do I call if I can't figure it out? And I was like, oh my fucking God, that has to be me. Because I'm the only one that knows about it. Am I willing to be that tech support? I know that if I put Windows on it, she can call my brother, my uncle, you know, her friends, kids can help her, all of that shit. Linux, I'm stuck with that. And that's also something we have to remember. When we are trying to convert people, again, it's the human side or the human factor. When we're trying to convert people to Linux, you end up being that support group, because if you say to them, here's Linux, figure it out yourself, most people will just be like, the first time they have a problem, they will just be like, fuck this shit, I don't want to spend 2-3 hours figuring this out, and I can't call anyone. Hey, Windows, come over here, get down on my hard drive again, because they know how it works. And I know a lot of people like, oh, they should invest in their operating system and blah, blah, blah. Again, are you investing in how your car is function? Are you invested in how to change the engine in your car? Are you invested in how to change the wiring harness in your car? It's the same thing. No, you are not. You just want to put your ass in the chair, turn the key, drive to McDonald's. You don't give a fuck about if the onboard operating system or the computer on your car is Linux, open source, or closed source. You don't give a fuck about that. You just give a fuck about if it works and can I get to McDonald's? Can I get to the pub? Most people see a computer just like a car. It's an appliance, it's a tool, it's something that get the work done. And is that good or bad? Well, is it bad that you don't know how your car function? Is it bad that you don't know how to change the overhead gasket in your car? Is it wrong that you don't know how to change the brakes on your car? It's the same thing. Exactly the same thing. Some people have a special interest in that side of computers, just like some people like to mess with cars in their spare time. And just imagine if every of your friends or all your friends that like to mess with cars in the spare time, every time you talk to them, they were nagging you to do the same thing because it's better and you save money and blah, 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 blah. You will be like, oh my fucking God, I don't want to talk to him. So we need to be better at talking to the human side and get this human factor on the wraps, because that's the biggest thing. I think that the biggest turnover, and that would only happen if Microsoft makes a Linux operating system, the biggest turnover will be if people could just sit down in front of a Linux machine with no learning whatsoever and use it. But that's not doable at all, unless you take the Windows experience and put a Linux kernel behind it. That may happen sometimes in the future with Windows. Until that happens, there will be a learning curve. Is the learning curve the same learning curve as going from Windows to Macintosh? You know, you go from Windows to Macintosh, you have to learn a little bit. And you go from Windows to Linux, you have to learn a little bit. The problem with Linux is like this fragmentation, you know. People, they want to just be pointed to one place. And the other thing is, we don't want to support them. We want them to use it, but we don't want to be the support. Oh, go to this forum. Go to this website and blah, blah, blah. Well, I don't have to do that on Windows. I just call my son or my brother or, you know, tech support. I don't have to sit and read angry geeks, read about angry geeks yelling at each other in a forum or on Reddit and stuff like that. We need to get that figured out. And this whole thing with, oh, but we have a great community. Yeah, you have a great community because you talk to people you like to talk to. You don't talk to assholes and idiots. It's the same thing. I have a great group of friends. Yeah, of course you have, because you are friends with people you like to be around with. But there are people out there that thinks that the group of people that you associate with and are your friends are the biggest assholes in the world, and the other way around. So you can't say I stay for the community, because it's like saying, oh, I'm staying in this town because of my friends. They are the best in the world. Yeah, of course they are. They are your friends. Your community is your community. You quickly find, I'm going on a little rant here, but you will quickly find in a group of people, you quickly find a clique of people, or a group of people you click with and stay with them. And then you get this feed, oh, this is a great community and everyone is so friendly and helpsome and blah, 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 blah. Because you start to do this and then you don't see all the other things going on around you. So we also need to step back and see like, oh. Anyway, this has been long. I bored you long enough. I'm out of here. What is your takes on the human factor? How can we get humans, I was about to say. How can we get this human factor into more videos? How can we get this human factor done better to make people change so they can use Linux? I'd love to hear that. See you all later. Bye bye.